Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to use the jump instruction and how to use the comments in the structured text. So for the jump instruction, it's similar to the jump instruction in any other programming language. We need to have a label, and then at the end of the label we will have this columns, and then we need to use the jump to the corresponding label inside the program. So this label should be unique overall the program, so you cannot have you can not use the same, let's say, variable name for the label and for some other variables inside the program. It should be unique and unambiguous. Regarding the comments, we can have comments in the structured text by these two ways. Let's say we can start commenting by this parentheses and the star, and this can include the multi-line commenting as well. So you start with this and then you end the commenting with star and parentheses. Or we can use this double slash to start commenting. We will see it in the program. So let's go to the codesys. Here, compared to the previous video, I have done some changes. Inside the repeat until loop, when we check the value for the reset, I've set a jump instruction. Instead of changing the value of time out directly to the 10, I've put jump to this label RES. Then here I have defined the RES label in which I'm changing the value of the time out to 10. So keep in mind that whenever we are inside the loop, inside the repeat loop, if the value for the reset becomes true, the execution will jump to this line. And so we will go outside of the repeat loop. In the other case, if we are inside the loop, inside the repeat loop, and the reset is not pressed, so this is not true. However, the condition for aborting the loop is true, then we will go out, and at the same time, in the next line of the code, the value for the timeout will become 10 again. So in each case, coming out of the loop, repeat loop, we will have the value for the timeout equal to 10. You will see it in the runtime. On the other hand, I have put some comments here. So here you can see that this is one way of creating comments in the structured text programming. Double slashes here and there, and then here I have multi-line commenting, starting with parentheses and star and ending with the star and parentheses. So it would be a good practice to provide comments in the code. Here, for example, you can write that with these two timers I am creating the 1 second intervals, okay, so and so on and so forth. It's better to provide comments, but it's better not to provide all the details, otherwise it would be quite difficult to follow the code. Okay, so let's run this code as well. Let's try again. Apparently something went wrong. Program loaded exception error occurred again. Let me see the reason and then I will fix it and come back. Alright, so here I have the program in the run mode. I just did change the name of the label to res1 and log in with download. Maybe it was the reason to log in with download, not with online change or without any change. So here, let's check how the jump works here. So if I set the start to true, here we will have the time out going down. And if I press the reset now, you see that the value for the timeout becomes 10. So whenever I reset, I press the reset. And if I press and hold it, the execution of the program jumps here in the if reset then jump to reset, it jumps to the line number 15 and the value for the timeout becomes 10. Then the instruction inside the repeat loop is executed, that is once the value for timeout becomes 9 and then it jumps to the line 15 and again it becomes 10. Here you cannot see when the value for the timeout becomes 9, but it's indeed the case. And if I release it, you will see that it starts to decrease. All right, so this is how you can use the jump instruction in the structured text and how you can provide some comments for the users inside the program. It's the same if you want to provide comments in the variable declaration area as well. Let me just stop and log out. Yeah, here if you want, you can provide some comment for the users. This is whatever variable. So the comments don't affect the execution of the program at all, but they provide some extra information for the users. All right, that's all for this video. I hope it was useful for you, and please don't forget to share it if you think that it will be useful for someone else to watch. Thanks for watching, and see you next.